Hello students, in the last class we are discussing about theoretical part of leave encashment, how it is exempted, to whom it is exempted, how much is exempted, for the purpose of claiming the exemption, what are the condition and what do you mean by salary for this purpose, we discussed in the previous class. Today we have to discuss about some examples or illustration, how much is taxable, how much is exempted with an example. Let us have an example. Mr. Narayan retired from his service after completing 25 years of service. So, his salary for 10 months preceding retirement was ₹36,900. He had 7 months earned leave. In his credit, on the basis of 30 days per year which was approved, he was paid ₹27,300 as leave salary. His lost on salary is ₹3,900. Now, on the basis of this example, we have to calculate what is his taxable earned revenue, what is his exempted earned revenue. As we discussed in the previous class about some format, how much is taxable, how much is exempted and which one you have to take, that we will discuss. Before going to that one, just have a look on this one. So, number of years of service 25 years, then monthly salary ₹36,000, that is 10 month salary, not monthly salary, it is 10 month salary, average 10 month salary, because we need average 10 month salary for the purpose of calculation, that is 36,900 and ₹27,300 is there now, that is earned leave encashment is received, employee receiving earned leave encashment of ₹27,300. Then ₹3,900 is there, no? It's a lost month salary drawn. So now on this basis we have to calculate tax liability. This 7 months is there, no? It is in his credit. 7 months is in his credit. Now let us discuss how we have to calculate the exempted leave encashment. Particulars, these two columns are amount columns, that is for inner column and outer column. First one, earned leave encashed or leave encashed, in the sense how much he encashed the leave, as we discussed in the problem, that is ₹27,300 he received. Out of this one, how much is exempted, how much is taxable, that we have to calculate it. As I said earlier, there is an exemption. Under section 10, subsection 10AA, the least of the following. So, some amounts are there. Out of these four, which one is least amount that is eligible to claim the exemption? The first one is statutory limit. As we discussed in the theoretical part, statutory limit as of now ₹3 lakh. Second one, amount received as a leave encashment, actual leave encashed amount. How much we discussed in the question? So he is receiving actually ₹27,300 here is there. Then average 10 month salary, average 10 month salary it was there in the question. Average 10 month salary, that is ₹36,900. The last one, the last month salary has to be multiplied by the amount of EL in his credit, that is nothing but amount of monthly salary into average, sorry, monthly salary on the basis of average 10 months. So that they have given the question. So that is nothing but 3690. This 3690 has to be multiplied by 7 months because we already taken he is having 7 months as credit. So monthly salary 3690, that is the last month salary drawn. And here 36,900 rupees, that is average 10 month salary, last 10 month salary. And that is 27,300, that is nothing but amount of leave encashment. And 3 lakh rupees, there is a statutory limit. As of now, this assessment here, statutory limit is 3 lakh. The product of these two multiplication is 25,830. Students, before going to consider which is the least amount, first you have to concentrate on whatever you have taken. I repeat, first you have to take into consider statutory limit, then you have to take into consider actual earned leave, then you have to consider average 10 month salary. Usually, sometimes in the question, they may not given this amount, that has to be multiplied by 10 on the basis of this amount. Sometimes they are given in the question, if they are given directly, we have to take entire amount 36,900 because it is 10 month salary. This 3690 is there, the last month salary drawn, because the last point has to be taken, last month salary drawn into how much of EL he is having in his credit at the time of retirement. So this is 7 months, see, so it is 25,830. Please remember, here we are calculating a non-government employee, he is receiving leave encashment at the time of retirement, because during the service fully taxable. If he is a government employee, fully exempted. But if he is a non-government employee receiving at the time of retirement, we have to take least of these 4 items. Out of these 4 items, which is the least amount? 27,300, 25,830, 36,900 and 3 lakh rupees. Very simple, it is 25,830. This 25,830 is the eligible exemption under section 10, subsection 10A. So we have to write this amount here. Then what is the balance? 27,300 minus 25,830. That is nothing but 1,470. What is this? Taxable leave encashment. Actually, is receiving how much leave encashment? 27,300, we are applying certain provisions as per the exemption. Out of that, 25,830 is the least amount. Out of the 27,000, 25,830 is exempted. And how much has to pay? 1,470 has to pay. In the sense, this 1,470 rupees will be included in the income from salary of a particular employee. So, this is a simple calculation. So, we have to concentrate on salary, how much credit and statutory limit and average 10 month salary. So, hope the students are understanding that calculation part. So, we have to discuss with different examples to understand. So, what leave encashment taxability. Thank you.